drawing breath. In bed at midnight, I keep the light after strapping on the mask armor against sleep apnea. Rise above this rape by air and into a Stephen King character whose problems are worse than an unforgiving sea storm forcing its way down a windpipe. A long balloon pumped to the point of burst, over and over, an insufficiency to exhale against the assault. Anxiety a little like death in its aloneness. On the ceiling, a crane fly competes with King's protagonist for my attention, flits from one glow-painted star to another. A wee astronaut exploring the solar system with wings that speak louder than written words. I look up its homepage on my laptop. She doesn't wonder which breath will be her last, doesn't know about her 3-day lifespan, doesn't even feel the need to eat. She knows another need and wants to find him fast, is willing to search the entire universe for one quick contribution to perpetuity. I could put a glass over her and turn her outside right now. Or I could wait for morning to become the fairy godmother of mating. Reach up and switch off her sun. Find solace in the shine of the smallest moon and stars. The flickering shadows of a familiar. An angel of mercy who brings breath like the slack tide.